हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम समद। आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व गेट एरोस्पेस रॉकेट प्रोपल्शन क्वेश्चन विच आस्क्ड इन 2009 एंड दिस पेपर हैड बीन ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय आईआईटी रुड़की। सो हियर इज द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन। क्लासीफाई द फ्लोइंग प्रोप्लेन्स एज क्रायोजेनिक्स सी। सो हियर द नेम इज डोनेटिंग शॉर्ट नेम दैट इज क्रायोजेनिक्स कॉल्ड सी, सेमी क्रायोजेनिक एस सी, कम प्रेस्ड गैस सी जी एंड द अर्थ स्टोरेबल ई एस। N2O4 UDMH नाइट्रो टेट्रा ऑक्साइड दैट इज द फुल नेम ऑफ UDMH। ओके, N2O4 मीन्स नाइट्रोजन टेट्रा ऑक्साइड एंड एंड अनसिमेट्रिकल डाईमिथाइल हाइड्रोजन। OLX RP1 लिक्विड ऑक्सीजन एंड क्रोसिन। LOX LH2 जो लॉकेट ऑक्सीजन एंड लिक्विड हाइड्रोजन। N2 इज द नाइट्रोजन गैस। So is there four following option? So which one is the ES and cryogenics? Okay, so I have to choose that from this option. Okay, so we have to know that. So these properties, what is the chemical properties and which gas belongs to, so you can easily find out. Okay, so using this we can find out N2O4 UDMH is the esterable. So C is the right answer here. Okay, that is the nitrogen gas. C formally cryogenic and semi cryogenic. SC is the semi cryogenic. CG is the compressed gas. Okay, so C is the right option. Okay, let's see second question. Let m not be the total mass, okay, of a single stage rocket. Mp is the total mass of the propellant, ml be the mass of the payload carried by the rocket, and ms be the mass of the inert structural components. If isp is the specific impulse of the propulsion and g is the acceleration due to gravity, then the maximum velocity that can be attained by the rocket vehicle in absence of gravity and atmospheric drag is given by. So actually this is the formula. Okay, if you know the formula, increment velocity or maximum velocity, that is the rocket dynamics. We have already studied this type of formulas. Okay, so we can easily find out. So actually formula is delta v is nothing but the final minus v initial. Final velocity minus initial velocity is nothing but the maximum velocity or increment velocity is equal to equivalent velocity, okay, into ln of initial mass, that is m naught, divided by final mass. Or we can write like that also, instead of v equivalent we can write isp into g ln of initial mass divided by final mass. Mf is the final mass, but here my final mass is not given. Okay, so as we know that initial mass is equal to final mass plus propellant mass. So final mass is equal to initial mass minus mp propellant mass. Okay, so we can write like that. Okay, isp into g ln of m naught divided by, instead of final mass we can write m naught minus mp. So we can see the option is d is the right option. Okay, so this is the formula. Actually we have to remember that this formula. So now we will see in next question. Next question is, the performance of a solid rocket motor is improved by replacing the old propellant with the new one. The new propellant gives a combustion temperature 40% higher than the previous propellant without appreciable change in molecular weight of the combustion products and other operating parameters. By approximately what percentage is the specific impulse of new motor higher than the old one? So there is the 5-line question. Okay, 5-line in this question. And if you know that there is only one statement is given. Okay, so we have to read very carefully because this is a very interesting, a very easy question if you understand this all line. Okay, what he is asking here is given you propellant gives a combustion temperature 40% higher than the previous propellant without the appreciable change in molecular weight. Okay, that is molecular weight is not changing. Okay, but temperature is 40% higher. So for a solid motor rocket propellant, we know that exhaust velocity is equal to, okay, under root gamma RT, okay, and R is nothing but the universal R gas constant, that is a gas constant formula, divided by molecular weight. Okay, M is not changing, so we no need to take R, so we can write V is equal to under root T. Okay, this is the relation, and as we know that ISP, a specific impulse, is equal to V divided by G. So we can write ISP in directly proportional to under root T, because V is equal to under root T. So let's see, here is the given the propellant. I have to find out the specific impulse, okay, new specific impulse. Percentage is the specific impulse of the new motor higher than the old one. We have to find out old one and new one. So let's assume that ISP 1 is 100, then temperature is 10. If temperature is 10, that is the 10, then ISP will be 100, okay. That is the magnitude scales. Okay, so that is a temperature 1. Okay, so if temperature 2 is given 40% higher than, so 10 plus 40% of 10, 40% of 10, what is will be the 1/4. Okay, then T2 becomes 14. So if T2 is 14, then what will be the ISP2? If you using this formula, ISP equal to under root T, then ISP2 becomes 196. Okay, that is the magnitude scales we have taken, because ISP equal to under root T. Okay, so ISP2 is the 196. So change in ISP, what will be the change in ISP? So just put the value 196 minus ISP 1 is 100 divided by ISP 100 into 100. So it becomes 96%. Okay, so 96% is the right option. So here we can see option B is the right option. Okay, now we will see next question. Next question is, a solid rocket motor has an in burning grain of cross sectional area. Okay, cross section area is given, density of the propellant is given, linear regression rate r dot, that is the r dot equal to 5 mm per second is given, that is burn rate or linear regression rate it is called. Okay, if the specific impulse of the propulsion system is ISP 200 second, the thrust produced by the motor is, so I have to find out the thrust. Okay, so first of all we have to find out mass flow rate. Mass flow rate is equal to rho p acs, a is given, okay, into r dot. This is the formula for mass flow rate. So what is a? A is 0.4. RP is 1500 into R dot is 5 mm per second. So we can write 5 into 10 to the minus 3 meter per second. So it will be 3 kg per second. That is the mass flow rate. Okay. And what is the formula for thrust? Thrust is equal to mass flow rate into GISP. Okay, so mass flow rate is 39.81 and ISP is given 200 is equal to almost 6 kilonewton. Okay, 6 kilonewton is the right answer. So here option B is the right option. Okay, so that all the 2009 question.